Hey everybody, Alan Lepofsky here, and I've been getting pinged all morning with questions about Slack's IPO, so I thought I would just share some quick thoughts. First and foremost, the only thing that really matters is congratulations. Congratulations, Stuart, Cal, and everyone involved. It's been a great rise to watch your company go from, you know, a video game company to something that has really kickstarted the collaboration industry. And I think that's the most important point. If it's Yammer, who was acquired by Microsoft, you know, a decade ago, whether it's Slack, whether it's Workplace by Facebook, Cisco teams, Microsoft teams, or Quip, where I work at with Salesforce, what matters the most to me is that people are starting to collaborate. Individuals are becoming more productive. Teams are working together across not only their division, the entire organization, across boundaries. That's what excites me, is that teamwork is starting to be much more common, much more simple than it used to be. And when you're looking at these tools, whichever one it is, what I implore you to focus on is purpose. Something I've called purposeful collaboration for quite some time. What is the business use case of why you're doing this? What is the business process? What is the workflow? You know, what goal are you trying to achieve? And does the tool you choose achieve that? Does it enable you to do better in getting your job done? So it's not just about something simple like, hey, let's replace email. It's about, can you move the business forward? At Quip, we call that a culture of action, where teams can stop being hindered in making decisions or being stagnant and not being able to move forward, to becoming a culture of action where you can actually get work done, make decisions quickly, fix things that are broken, engage with people that need to be spoken to, all of those things. So what purpose are you choosing these tools for? But anyway, back to today's IPO. Congratulations, Slack. Thanks for sort of kickstarting the collaboration industry. And I look forward to hearing stories about how all of you out there are using various team collaboration tools to get work done. If there's any questions I can answer about Quip and Quip for Salesforce, please let me know. This has been Alan Lepofsky. Hope to talk to you later. Bye.